Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. The world we live in is driven by programming. And Python is one such language which is known to have had an exponential effect in making the programming world a better place. By using its concepts and strengths, Python has helped a lot of companies to drive their businesses to success. This is considered as one of the most important aspects in today's world of programming and business development. So in today's session, we'll give you a quick introduction to the world of Python. So now before we move ahead, make sure you have subscribed to our channel and also press the bell icon so that you never miss an update from Intellipaat. Also, if you are interested in doing a Python certification course, Intellipaat provides an end-to-end Python certification training. The details for the same are given in the description box below. So now let's look at the agenda for this session. So we'll start off by understanding what is Python and where it is used. Then we'll go through the step-by-step process of installing the Anaconda distribution for Python. And then finally, we'll set up and verify the Jupyter Notebook and the Spyder environment in Python. So without any further ado, let's begin with this session.
Let us begin by taking a quick introduction to what Python actually is. Guys, we already know Python is an interpreted language, it's an object-oriented language, and it is a high-level programming language which uses a lot of dynamic semantics, right? So basically, Python is the superpower of a programming language to be in existence today. And Python is one among the trendiest languages to learn, to work with, and the language which pretty much pays you the highest salary in this particular era as well, guys. So again, Python has amazingly simple syntax, it is very easy to learn, it's very easy to use, has very high readability, and again it reduces the cost of program maintenance as well. It supports a lot of modules, a lot of packages, again which again at the end of the day helps you with program modularity and code reuse, and all of these extensive standard libraries which are available, right? So they're pretty much free and open source. So the entire Python language is free, and we have an amazing community, probably the biggest community for a programming language right now for us Python guys. So you might be wondering where Python is used, right? Well, Python is used in YouTube, Google, NASA, Netflix, BitTorrent, Raspberry Pi, and so much more, guys. Python has been so subtly integrated into your life, in and around you, that you might not even know it. So if you're watching, this particular video on your smartphone, well, pretty much Python is working there as well. If you're watching this, on your computer, let's say you're just browsing through YouTube and you just landed on this video, well, guys, YouTube knows what video it has to recommend for you next, right? So it's pretty much YouTube's algorithm, machine learning and artificial intelligence algorithms working in the backend to suggest you videos. So let's say you're just watching this introductory video towards Python, and next it suggests the Intellipaat's Python full course video for you guys on YouTube, which is already present. Well, how does YouTube come to know this? Well, pretty much they make use of Python and a lot of machine learning models to analyze what you would like to view, and then they pretty much go on to suggest the same things, guys. So without further ado, let's quickly jump into how we can install Anaconda Python on Windows, guys. I've broken it down to a couple of very simple steps, and the first step to install Anaconda Python is to pretty much visit their website anaconda.com/downloads or anaconda.com/distribution, and here it's very simple and straightforward, guys. All you need to do is you need to click on the download button, and then you'll be greeted with two different options. One is for the Python 3.7 version and the other is for the Python 2.7 version, guys. Well, depending on what your particular requirement is, well, a majority of the frameworks, a majority of the libraries, and majority of the big companies pretty much make use of Python 3 these days. But in case if you have a legacy application where you will require Python 2.7, well, Python 2.7 is available here, guys. So you pretty much need to just hit the download button and just wait for it to download, guys. It's pretty much somewhere around 500 megabytes. Yeah, 462 megabytes. So that's probably going to take a couple of minutes, guys. So anyway, so first step is pretty simple. All you need to do is go to their website, and as you already know, as you can already see, it says it's the world's most popular Python and R data science platform, and I think I agree with this, guys, because I've been into data science for a couple of years now, and I've pretty much used Anaconda a lot as well. So again, this is the screen we just discussed, which is step two. Pretty much you can install Python 3.7 or Python 2.7 as per your requirement, and then the step three is again a very simple one. All you need to do is open the install, and then you'll be presented with the screen. I'll just guide you through the screen. So let's quickly make sure that our Anaconda is being downloaded right now. In my particular case, I'm downloading the 3.7 version. So as soon as it downloads, we can run it, guys. Guys, that just took about 5 minutes or so. So this is the screen you'll be pretty much greeted with as soon as you open the Anaconda installer. It's pretty simple, guys. All you need to do is hit next.
A quick info, guys. If you're interested in doing a Python certification course, Intellipaat provides an end-to-end Python certification training. The details for the same are given in the description box below.
Hit agree to their license agreement. And then here, you'll have to check if you have to install just for you or just for all the users. And if you're going to install it for all the users, you obviously are going to need admin privileges, guys. So let me just quickly hit next and type in my admin password. You can just install just for you and that would still work as well. But since you're installing it once, sort of better do it right? So here, you have two options. One is adding Anaconda to the system path variable. Well, I would not recommend you do this because it sort of causes problems if you have to reinstall and uninstall Anaconda later. But then it's not ticked by default. So all you have to do is pretty much go on to hit install and then it'll go on to install Anaconda for you guys. So again, this will take about a minute or so. I'm hoping somewhere around 3 to 5 minutes. So let's give it the time. And as soon as it installs, we'll see what's next, guys. So that took about somewhere in between 3 to 5 minutes, and it takes quite some time just because of the fact that it needs to install all of the libraries that Python come with, and it has to install Spyder and all of these dependencies as well, guys. So if it takes more than 5 minutes, do not worry, it'll happen and then it'll be ready by the end of 5 minutes, guys. So pretty much we can hit next, and now Anaconda and JetBrains are working together as well. They pretty much bring you the PyCharm IDE, which I already have, so I will not go ahead and do anything about it. So coming to the next step is you need to verify if Anaconda Python has already been installed. So hit start and just type Anaconda. You can pretty much get it for ANA as well. Anaconda prompt, there we go. Let us quickly run Anaconda prompt to check if everything is working. Well, we can go on to type Python. Well, Python console is ready. Let's quickly enter say Python's hello world. And let me hit enter, say hello world. So Python is working well here. So now we've pretty much set up Anaconda, guys. So we need to verify a couple of things as well. So we already just opened Anaconda and typed Python. We can run a small code again. This is just another mathematical code to just check if it's working. We just ran the hello world code. So it's pretty much working right, guys. So next up, we need to check out how we can open up the Jupyter Notebook, which comes already installed with Anaconda, guys. So here at the top, if you can check out, it pretty much says Jupyter Notebook. Let me quickly go ahead and run Jupyter Notebook. It'll just take a second to start up and it's going to open a browser tab for us. And there we go. So if you're at this page, then there's a very good chance that Jupyter Notebook is running. To verify, let me click new on the right side and then click Python 3. So this is going to create a new Python notebook for us. Let me just type in another just a print statement to check if everything's working. Hello from Intellipaat. So here's the run command. As soon as I click the run command, you must get the valid output, guys. So here as well, Jupyter Notebook has been set up and it's that easy, right? So it's just a small couple of steps and everything is coming together at once. So we just verified it using a small piece of code. Here I just used a hello world code for demonstration. And now we need to check if Spyder is working. Again, Spyder has automatically been installed for us alongside Jupyter and Anaconda prompt. So let me quickly run Spyder. It's gonna take a second to open up and then we can pretty much again execute another simple code to check if it's working, and then we can validate if it's working fine, guys. Well, Spyder just opened up. It just took about a minute to open up and it was minimized. So here again, we can run a basic code to check out if Spyder is working or not. Again, let me go with a print statement here. Welcome learners. This is just to check if it's working or not, guys. As soon as I hit print, as you can check out, there's already the output which got printed on the right side. Let me just go to full screen. Yeah, that's better. So basically, Spyder is again a very good interactive IPython console, which you can pretty much go on to use for all your particular cases. If you just want a simple mathematical operations, then we can perform that as well. So A equal to 10. B equal to 20, C equal to A plus B. I just have this habit of putting a space everywhere, so the print. Let's just print C for this particular case. As soon as we go at the output should be 30, right? The output is 30, guys. So it is as simple as this to set up Anaconda, to set up Python, to set up a Jupyter Notebook, and to set up Spyder all at once just using one installer from Anaconda, guys. So yeah, again, we just entered the sample Python code to verify if it is working, and it does.
A quick info, guys. If you are interested in doing a Python certification course, Intellipaat provides an end-to-end Python certification training. The details for the same are given in the description box below. I hope this session was informative. If you have any queries, you can type it in the comment section below. We'll reach out to you as soon as possible. And thank you for watching this video, and happy learning.